लेटेस्ट अपडेट्स और ताजा तरीन खबरों के लिए टीवी वन इंडिया लाइव को सब्सक्राइब कीजिए और नोटिफिकेशन पाने के लिए बेल आइकॉन को दबाना मत भूलिए।
मेंबर्स ऑफ द वेनरेटेड महासंघा, प्राइम मिनिस्टर्स ऑफ नेपाल एंड श्रीलंका, माय मिनिस्टर कलीग्स श्री प्रहलाद सिंह एंड श्री किरण रिजिजू जी, सेक्रेटरी जनरल ऑफ इंटरनेशनल बुद्धिस्ट कन्फेडरेशन, वेनरेबल डॉक्टर धम्मा पिया जी, रिस्पेक्टेड स्कॉलर्स, धम्मा फॉलोअर्स, सिस्टर्स एंड ब्रदर्स फ्रॉम अराउंड द वर्ल्ड, नमो बुद्धाय, नमस्ते। I am honored to address you all on the special day of Vaisak. Vaisak is a day to celebrate the life of Lord Buddha. It is also a day to reflect on the noble ideals and sacrifices he made for the betterment of our planet. Friends, last year also I had addressed a Vaisak Day program. That program was dedicated to all frontline workers leading humanity's fight against the COVID-19 pandemic. A year later, we are seeing a mix of continuity and change. The COVID-19 pandemic had not left us. Several nations, including India, have experienced a second wave. This is the worst crisis humanity faces in decades. We have not seen a pandemic like this for a century. This once-in-a-lifetime pandemic has brought tragedy and suffering at the doorstep of many. The pandemic has impacted every nation. The economic impact is huge as well. Our planet will not be the same after COVID-19. In the times to come, we will certainly remember events as either pre-COVID or post-COVID. But over the last year, there have been many noteworthy changes as well. We now have a better understanding of the pandemic, which strengthens our strategy to fight it. Most importantly, we have the vaccine, which is absolutely important to save lives and defeat the pandemic. The emergence of a vaccine in a year of the pandemic striking shows the power of human determination and tenacity. India is proud of our scientists who have worked on the COVID-19 vaccines. Through this forum, I would like to once again salute our first responders, frontline healthcare workers, doctors, nurses, volunteers who selflessly risk their lives every day to serve others in need. To those who have suffered and lost their near and dear ones, I would like to extend condolences. I grieve with them. Friends, by studying the life of Lord Buddha, there is mention of the four sides. These four sides brought Lord Buddha face to face with human suffering. At the same time, It ignited within him the desire to devote his life to removing human sufferings. Lord Buddha taught us, Bhavatu Sabba Mangalam. Blessings, compassion, and welfare of all. In the last year, we have seen several individuals and organizations rise to the occasion and do everything possible to reduce suffering. I have also learnt of the generous contribution of equipment and materials made by the Buddhist organizations. Followers of Buddha Dharma from world over. The scale, both in terms of population and geographical space, of the task is huge. Humanity has been humbled. By the outpouring of generosity and support from fellow humans, these actions are in line with the teachings of Lord Buddha. It manifests the supreme mantra of Appa Dipo Bhava. Friends, COVID-19 is certainly a major challenge we face. While we do everything possible to fight it, we must not lose sight of the other challenges humanity faces. One of the biggest challenges is that of climate change. Reckless lifestyle of the present threatens the coming generations. Weather patterns are changing. Glaciers are melting. Rivers and forests are in danger. We cannot let our planet remain wounded. Lord Buddha put emphasis on a way of life where respect for Mother Nature is paramount. I am proud to share that India is among the few large economies to be on track to completing their Paris targets. For us, sustainable living is not only about right words, it is about the right actions. Friends, the life of Gautam Buddha was about peace, harmony, and coexistence. Today, there are still forces remaining whose existence depends on spreading hate, terror, and mindless violence. Such forces do not believe in liberal democratic principles. The need of the hour is for all those who believe in humanity to come together and defeat terror and radicalization. For that, the path shown by Lord Buddha is absolutely relevant. Lord Buddha's teachings and the importance given to social justice can become a global unifying force. He rightly said, Natti Santi Paran Sukham. There is no higher bliss than peace. Friends, Lord Buddha was the reservoir of brilliance of the entire universe. From him, we all could draw light from time to time and take the path of compassion. Universal responsibility and welfare. Mahatma Gandhi rightly said about Gautam Buddha, and I quote, Buddha taught us to defy appearances and trust in the final triumph of truth and love, unquote. Today, on Buddha Purnima, let us renew our commitment to the ideals of Lord Buddha. I join you all in praying to the triple gem to provide relief from the testing times of global COVID-19 pandemic. Thank you. Thank you very much.